It's me, Lucy. I am excited to be with you this morning. We're going to have a ton of fun. I've got some fun things planned for you. So here we go. First, before we start, as always, just want to remind you, I think you're a VIP, which means you have value, identity in Jesus, and God has a plan and a purpose for your life, which means you're super important and valuable. I mean, we wouldn't be the same without you. So just remember that. Now, this morning, we're going to be talking about reacting versus responding. Now, if I think about reacting, kind of what comes to mind for you guys if you react to something? Is it usually calm? Is it usually very peaceful? Or is it usually kind of surprising? Like if one of your brothers or sisters comes out from behind the door and scares you, what's your reaction? It's like, ah! It's a reaction, right? It's like what first pops up. And a response is maybe something that's a little more thought out, a little more thought through and slow. It's usually calmer. So here, let me give you an example. If someone says, you know what, you smell like stinky cheese. Now a reaction might be like, no, you smell like stinky cheese. Now a response might be, well, that's not very nice to say, and I took a bath today, so honestly, I don't smell like stinky cheese. You see how there's two different ways we can approach the same thing? We either react with a lot of emotion and a lot of sometimes anger, or we can sit back, be calm, not take things personally, and respond in a kind manner. Okay, so since we're talking about reacting and responding today, I thought it would be fun to do a little game with you guys before we get into today's lesson. So we're gonna play a reaction game. Now, if you were here, the game would look a little bit different, but this is a trend on the internet right now, so I thought it'd be fun if we all tried it together. So a song is gonna play and there's gonna be a bar of different hand gestures above my head. And when the beat drops, you're supposed to go with the beat to make different hand gestures, whatever is on the top of the screen. So it's kind of like you're trying to do it. Now it's really hard actually. I had a very difficult time because my finger coordination isn't very good. My reaction time wasn't very good. So let's see if maybe you guys are better than me. I'm gonna show you a few of my videos and give you a couple different tries to see how good you can do. You're probably already better than me. Da-da-da-da. When I popped off, then you go gave me just a little bit of a chop. Baby, so cold, he from the north, he from the da-da-da-da. When I popped off, then you go gave me just a little bit of a chop. Da-da-da-da. When I popped off, then you go gave me just a little bit of a chop. Da-da-da-da. When I popped off, then you go gave me just a little bit of a chop. Da 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 da. When I popped off, then you go gave me just a little bit of a chop. Baby, so cold, he from the north. So, now to take that a step further, Jesus says something really interesting in Luke chapter 6. So I want to read that to you guys today, and then we are going to do our own experiment on reaction. This is Luke 6, 27. But you who are willing to listen, I say, love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Bless those who curse you, and pray for those who hurt you. If someone slaps you on the cheek, offer the other cheek also. If someone demands your coat, offer your shirt too. Give to anyone who asks. And when things are taken away from you, don't try to get them back. Do to others as you would like them to do to you. Now, Jesus, someone slapped me in the face. I'm not gonna say, please slap me again on this other side, right? Or if someone steals my very favorite North Face jacket, I'm not gonna strip off my shirt and give that to them too. Wait, is that how we're supposed to respond? Jesus is saying, go the extra mile. Be peacekeepers. Do to others what you would want to have done to you. So we're not supposed to be doormats. We're not supposed to be allowed to be walked on. But Jesus does want us to respond in love. And that kind of takes the power away from the bully, or takes the power away from someone who's trying to hurt us. Now, Jesus calls us to respond in selfless ways. But in order to do that, we have to evaluate our own hearts. So really, and maybe your mom has taught you this before, what's in your heart comes out. And that's true in science too. What you put in comes out. So what's on the inside of you? That's my question for you today. What fills your heart and your mind and your attitudes? Are you full of joy and goodness and God's love for people? Or are you full of jealousy and fear and hurt and sadness? Remember, what's on the inside of you, it comes out. When we're under pressure, when we're squeezed tight, maybe by something that isn't going our way, or a hard trouble, or, you know, just a frustrating circumstance, it's like we get squeezed and squeezed and squeezed, and eventually something's gonna come out. Is it good or is it bad? We speak and act out of what is going on inside of our own hearts. Even more so when we're under pressure, the things inside of us can explode and affect the people around us. So let's go do a little science experiment and let's see what happens when there's pressure and maybe how we should respond in the best way. Is what's gonna come out of us good or bad? See, Jesus doesn't promise that everything's gonna be rainbows and unicorns. You know, he says that we're gonna go through hardship and trials. He says there's gonna be really tough times. So how do we respond when those tough times come? Let's go see. All right, so I am outside the church, and as you can see behind me, I have two bottles of Diet Coke. Now, for our purposes, we are gonna pretend that one is filled with good things, and one is filled with gross things, like maybe sewage water. So one is filled with, what's your favorite soda in the whole world? Mine is probably Dr. Pepper. Holla! So one is Dr. Pepper and one is sewage water. And what we're gonna see is when we're in pressure-filled situations, something's gonna come out. So we're gonna see if good comes out or bad comes out. So let's go ahead, and I have Mentos. They're those like chewy, minty candy, ready to go. And a chemical reaction actually forms when you put the two together. So I am going to show you, and hopefully it is good. So hopefully you can see it totally kind of created a rocket. Now this time I'm going to attempt to put these Mentos in the other one and put the cap on really, really fast and see how, if we can get it to like explode. So I don't know if you could see that, but it was already starting to fizz and go crazy when I shut it. So what I'm gonna do is drop it on the cap, and I'm gonna see if it makes a rocket. As you can see, when things are pressurized, when we go through these trials and tribulations, you know, we are going to react. And we react with attitudes, react with what's stored up in our heart. So, you know, what's stored up in our heart when we go through bad things? Is God's faithfulness and goodness and joy stored up in our heart? So that way we can trust in those things. And that joy and goodness is such a peace to others? Or when we're filled with pressure, are bad things gonna come out like sewage water? That would be super gross. So that was a fun science experiment. Let's go back inside for a minute. Wow, wasn't that crazy? That was so much fun. If you guys wanna try that at home, first ask your mom and dad. But I would suggest getting a Diet Coke, big 2 liter. And the reason why diet works better is because it's less sticky to clean up afterwards because there's less sugar. And then Mentos, which are these little candies, these little mint candies. So, I want you to think about this. One of those bottles. There, my breath is so minty fresh. Here, I'll let you guys smell it. Can you smell it through the camera? I know you can't smell through the camera. Okay, I get it. So, anyways, if one of those bottles was really filled with something good like Dr. Pepper, and let's say one of those bottles really filled with something nasty like sewage water, isn't it funny how something as little as this, some little trouble or trial, affects both of them, right? They both went under pressure. And they both exploded. But one, it exploded and it got all over me. And pretend that was the sewage water one. Ugh, I'd have to go take all these clothes off, change my clothes, maybe take a shower, just because someone else's reaction got nasty stuff all over me. Now, later on in Luke chapter 6, which is where we were reading before, it says, a good man brings good things out of the good stored up in his heart. So when we store up good things in our heart, good comes out. But an evil man who brings evil things and stores evil in his heart, man, that evil comes out. And then this is what the Bible says, for the mouth speaks what the heart is full of. You know, we would never speak something that doesn't really sound like something we would say, right? Like, I'm not just gonna go off and start speaking Chinese because that's not stored up in my heart. I don't know how to speak Chinese. So, you know, what's stored in your heart? Is it good? Or maybe is it a little smelly? And this is how we can kind of tell. Picture this story, okay? If your parents tell you to clean your room, what is your first reaction? Is your first reaction to maybe just get really mad and say, no way, I don't want to. I hate cleaning my room. And then you run into your room and you slam the door? Or is your reaction maybe a little bummed because you don't really want to stop playing and clean your room, but you go to your room and you do it anyways as quick as you can and you do your best. Now, what's the result in each circumstance? How is your parents gonna react to the things that was stored up in your heart and your attitude towards them? If you storm off, do you think you're gonna get away with that and it's gonna be good for you? Or do you think it would just be better overall if you just listened, you obeyed, and you went in there quickly and you got it done so you could go back to playing? We choose our attitude, but our attitude comes from what's stored up in our hearts. So I know you're probably asking this question already. How do we store up good things in our hearts? How do we maybe change what's in our hearts, or how do we make sure we're not storing up evil things? That, my friend, is a very good question. It's by changing the way that we think. Right up here, okay? What we think is kind of what is in our hearts. Philippians 4:8 says, "Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things." And that's how we store up good in our heart, because we think on good things. Let's pray. Jesus, thank you for who you are. And honestly, we want to respond in the right way. And we know that in order to respond in the right way, we need to store up good in our hearts. And if we want to store up good in our hearts, then we need to think about what is good and pure and lovely and kind. Help us to do those things this week. In Jesus' name, amen. Da, 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 da. When I popped off, then you go gave me just a little bit of luck. Da, 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 da. When I popped off, then you go gave me just a little bit of luck.